In this tutorial, I will show you how to share screen on Zoom for Windows. For you to share a screen on Windows, laptop or PC, you will need to join a meeting and have permission from the host. When you are in a meeting, please click on the app. Now, the menu from the bottom appears. Click on the share button. You have here lots of options. On top of this window, we have three options: Basic, Advanced and Files. Let's explain a bit every option. The screen option is simply the share of the screen. You will see all of the info from your current screen. When you share a whiteboard, you will get a whiteboard table that you can write and draw. This is very useful if you are a teacher that wants to share the screen on Zoom. Another option on the Basic tab is iPhone/iPad. You can use this option if you wish to share the screen for your iPad and iPhone. You will be able to connect your phone to your Wi-Fi and share directly on the PC your screen. It is essential to notice two options: Share computer sound and optimize screen sharing for video clips. I always use these two options. The first option will allow other people to hear what I hear on the computer. So, if I play a video, if this option is not checked, the participants will not hear the sound. The other option will make so the participants will see almost in real time what I do on the screen. Let's click on Advanced to talk also about these options. If you select the share portion of a screen, then you will be able to share only a part of the screen. This will give you the possibility to use the other parts of the screen for preparing the data. You can also share music or computer sounds only. And if you have multiple cameras on your computer, even content from your second camera. Let's tap on Files tab. We can share files from different cloud providers. I now have only three providers: Microsoft, Google and Box. Let's try to share a whiteboard for now. You will see here lots of options. But first thing what you need to know, if you do not wish somebody else to use the whiteboard, go with the mouse near Stop Share. The menu bar will pop up. Now, click on the three dots from the bar. You have here multiple options like Disable Participants Annotation or even Show Names of Annotators, so you will see who makes the annotation on the whiteboard. Also, you have a great option on Remote Control. You can give control of your mouse to somebody to write on the whiteboard. If you are a teacher and you wish somebody to write, you can set up that. The rest of the options are pretty basics: Text, Draw, Spotlight, Format. But they are what you need. My advice to you is to try to test it yourself, so you will be able to use it without any problems. I advise you to create a meeting for yourself and play around with all of these settings to understand how they work. I will mention the option for Save and Clear. The Clear option will allow you to delete any drawings that are not yours, or just your drawings, or all drawings. Also, the Save option will allow you to keep what you worked on the whiteboard. Now, let's stop sharing the whiteboard. Let's share the full screen now. The green borders show you what part of the screen does the other participant see. All of the data that you see on the screen will be shared with others. Here, you also have the option to remote control, so you can give access to anybody to control your PC. Now, let's try an advanced option: Portion of the screen. The green border part is the zone you share with your viewers. You can resize this quite easily by going with the mouse over and click and drag. When the border is orange, then it means the sharing is paused. Let's do a quick test. This is the only part of the screen that the other participants see. Let's also share a file on Zoom to see how this looks. Click here to authorize. Select your account. Tap here Allow. Here again tap Allow. The first time I tried, I got an error. Let me try again. Now it works. If this happens to you, do not worry. Try again. Select the file and click the share screen. Click Open Zoom. You will have here the same option as the whiteboard. You can annotate this file or just remote control somebody. Test yourself these options to understand it better, but they are mostly the same as whiteboard. Now, let's stop the screen share and see the last option we will talk about. When you have multiple windows open, Zoom can share only that software or window. I have on my PC a Google Drive and File Explorer. If I select Google Chrome, then all the other windows will not be visible to others. So this is very useful not to show what we do not wish. Let's say we have a presentation and we wish to show only the Excel software, not other stuff on the computer. We select this and click Share. What we do on the rest of the computer, even if it's on the same screen, will not be seen by others. If I try to do something else on the PC, on another app, you will see that the sharing option will be paused and others will not see anything that I do. My opinion is that if you are a teacher or you wish to do a professional presentation, use Zoom for Windows. This is by far the most advanced version of Zoom, and also have options that on other devices do not work. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.